the basics. Ollie's like a little bird. Crunch, crunch.
Reading in class, one of the basic 3 R's at the heart of education. And despite the advance of science and technology in school curriculums, it's this basic skill that still causes most problems. 22% of Ilya's pupils do not speak English at home, and the authority's chief inspector has also been critical of literacy standards. Here at Woodmanston Primary in Streatham, they've been carrying out a pilot scheme to update language skills. This is the London Reading Test, the main assessment for primary pupils before going to secondary school. They simply fill in the missing words. But now it's proposed that these children aged between 8 and 9 be tested at 3 stages, when they're 7, 11 and 13. By linking these tests to yearly continual assessments, the educationists believe they can monitor progress more carefully. But there could be opposition from teachers to replacing intelligence checks, called verbal reasoning, with the London Reading Test.
Well, I can only accept the advice of our chief inspector, whose job it is to give the information to members about the best way of assessing attainment. His view, and it's the view I think of many experts, is that this is a better way of testing and anticipating and diagnosing the good pupils, the pupils that are underachieving and those that are overachieving, than an intelligence test.
The ILEA hope to introduce their changes into the classroom in the next school year from September 1988, but they'll be discussed at the authority's subcommittees next week. They say that the results of new tests will be open to parents and that they'll ensure no children's needs will be overlooked. Mark Longhurst with Ilya's Young Pupils.